Recently, Z-Image has caused a sensation in the open source community. Although the quality of the images generated by this model is not the best, considering its overall performance and speed, many people might think this is a fantastic model. Due to its capabilities, the entire ecosystem is also constantly being improved. Today, we will teach you how to use AI Toolkit to train Z-Image's LoRA. What you are seeing now is the AI Toolkit page on GitHub. This tool has a very complete front end, so everyone will find it very easy to use. Below, we will introduce the entire process of Z-Image LoRA training from beginning to end. First, let's look at the training results. This is a standard Z-Image workflow. I added the LoRA I trained after the original model. Let's first look at the effect of this LoRA. For easy testing, I uploaded a reference image and then used QWBL to generate a text-to-image prompt. Then we let it replicate the image. This way, I don't have to frequently write prompts because our focus is still on character consistency, right? Let's look at the character we generated. The overall quality is still very high. Of course, we do not recommend setting the weight to 1 point or when using it. I still recommend adjusting it to 0.75. Take a look. This way, the character will look more natural. In addition, the LoRA we trained also has some other uses, because we all know that models like Z-Image are very sensitive to prompts. For example, if I input an Oriental character, we can generate it. Since I set it to 0.75, you will get a very perfect face with mixed race features. It will be very beautiful. Look at the generated character. It will have some characteristics of your LoRA, but it is also affected by the prompt. You will get a very beautiful face using this face. You can then train other LoRAs. Therefore, this method can also be used for generating virtual characters. Next, let's talk about dataset construction. For the dataset, we generally need one image and a prompt. All datasets initially start with an original image. For example, my original image is this one. Now, I want to generate other images based on this one. There are many models you can choose from. The first is Fiber Image Plus, using the reference generation method. Let's see, we can generate a scene where this character is in the rain. Of course, by switching different prompts, you can generate different images. We still recommend that you should include images of the character in different shots and different angles. This way, you try to ensure diversity. The second model we recommend everyone use is Nano Banana, for example. We can upload this image and at the same time set a prompt and then generate the corresponding reference image. This is also possible. However, we do not recommend using Nano Banana Pro. Why? Because this model actually has a decline in its ability for character consistency. For example, let's take a look. We upload the same image with the same prompt. Look at the generated character. You will find that its consistency is not that good. We recommend that the number of generated datasets should be more than 10 images. If there are too few, the training effect may not be guaranteed. Please note that my entire program is placed in the root home directory. Therefore, the path you are in should be inside the root under the root directory. Then we enter AI Toolkit and then enter UI and use this command to start it. Then we set a password here. For example, I set it to 123,456. Then you just wait for it to start. Regarding the commands we just mentioned, you can see them on its official website. This is the command to start it in Linux. This is Windows. This is Windows PowerShell. I am currently using Linux, so I first set a password. We will use this when logging in because you don't want the external service to allow others to log in. Since our front end is developed using Node, yes, we will use the npm command to start this front end project. Our port is 8765. I didn't change this. It is the default. Then you can see this interface. The first thing you need to do is change the setting. In the settings, you need to set up the Hugging Face token. How to set this up? You can go to your own Hugging Face. After logging in, you can click on the personal profile picture. Further down, we have something called Access Token. At this time, you will be asked to enter your own password. After we confirm, everyone can set their own access token. Since I have already used this token in the image to prevent misuse, I will delete it now. Then, let's create a new one. Select read, meaning we create a read-only token. This way, others will not change your content. Then we create a token. You should copy this token as much as possible and save it. Generally, after a token is created once, you cannot view it again later. Then, Everyone pastes this token into this location, then we save the setting. Below, we create a dataset. The method for creating a dataset is actually very simple. We directly create a new dataset. Then the name can be anything below. We upload images, which includes two parts. The first is the images named with serial numbers, and the second is the prompts named with the same name. These are text files. We select all of them. I currently have 18 images. Let's open them. Make sure that every image has a corresponding prompt. Please note, we try to include our trigger word here. All my trigger words here are Cindy because the trigger word for all the LoRAs I trained is this. After that, we can create a new job. We click New Job. First, give this LoRA a name. Try to include the version number here. You don't need to write the trigger word, because each of our images has a detailed prompt. The key is this part. Let's select the model. This model must be Z image, then enable LoRAM for the rank value. We select 32, then we save a model every 250 steps. We don't need to adjust the training part. The batch size defaults to 1. If your video memory is large, you can set it to 2. As for the learning rate, we keep this part as default. Moving down the dataset part here, we select the dataset we just created. Also, regarding the resolution, you can choose 512, 768, and 1024. Then this is our sampling part. Sample every 250 steps. The sampling resolution is 1024 x 1024. The seed is 42. Guidance is selected as 1. And the sampling steps are 8. Below are the prompts used when we sample. After every 250 steps, we will run the model with these prompts to see how effective your LoRA generation is. We kept about 5 of them. You just try to make sure your prompt contains your trigger word. But I need to tell everyone here that the trigger word can be present or absent. In fact, the trigger word is not important for character LoRAs. The purpose of doing this is just to make it look more standardized. Next, we can start this training job. We click the start button. Now it starts executing. The first step is to download the model. Since my models have already been downloaded, it will load the model directly. The Z image model is relatively small, so it is not as large as our WAN 2.1 or WAN 2.2. Now we start generating images. Generating this image is mainly the zeroth sampling. The first time it is generated, there's no LoRA involvement because the LoRA has not started training yet. Okay, now the image generation is complete. Let's look at the samples. Then it will enter the training phase. There's a progress bar below and the corresponding time. I am currently training 3,000 steps. Since I have a 48G graphics card, my training takes about an hour and a half. So, the training speed is relatively fast. I won't train anymore here because I have already trained it before. We will look directly at my previous job. Everyone can click on the training queue and find the model we had before. We can directly look at the training process. I used about an hour and a half. Then we focus on the samples. It samples every 250 steps. Pay attention to its changes. The convergence speed of Z image is very obvious. Notice at step 0, the character is still completely generated freely. But notice that at step 250, the characteristics of the character have been fully highlighted. Therefore, your training steps do not necessarily have to be 3,000. Of course, according to my training habits, I still prefer to use 3,000 steps to train all the details. After training is completed, everyone can see the corresponding saved LoRAs here. It will save 5 by default, which are the last 5. We save 1 every 250 steps, so you can see the corresponding numbers. And this final LoRA does not have a number. Generally, we just download this LoRA and put it into your workflow, and then you can use it. The testing workflow is the one we just showed you. Please note that you don't need to worry too much about the trigger word here. It can be present or absent. Regarding the installation of AI Toolkit, we had a very detailed description in a previous video in the latter half of the video. If you are interested, you can take a closer look at that video, because as we just mentioned, although this model is not top-notch in every capability, its capabilities in every aspect are not weak. This leads many people to choose this model. Okay, that is all for today. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.